दिस मंडेज टेस्ट आई हैव गिवन यू टॉपिक टॉपिक आई हैव सेंड ऑन द ग्रुप
यस सर
इट इज मेजरमेंट स्केलर वेक्टर सर्कुलर मोशन ग्रेविटेशन ओनली दिस फोर चैप्टर Anybody is having doubt in measurement or scalar vector or circular motion?
Sir, the vernier caliper wala part in measurements.
Vernier caliper wala part. Okay. Gravitation. So whenever we talk about gravity, that means it is related to planetary forces. We deal with only Earth as a planet because baki ka itna explore hua nahi. So whenever there is some, we are into gravity, that means there will be some pulling force. These forces are between masses. So according to Newton, every particle of a matter attracts every particle of another matter by force. That magnitude of force is given by Newton's law of gravitation. What is Newton's law of gravitation? Force of attraction between two masses is directly proportional to product of mass, inversely proportional to square of distance between them. So F equals to G M1 M2 upon R square. This is formula for gravitational force between two masses. What is G called as? Any name for G? Yes, any name for G? Already I have written G is called as what? Universal gravitational constant. Hello?
Yes.
Yes.
What is value of G? 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. What is dimension of G? To know dimension of G, I can recollect this formula or unit Newton meter square per kg square. Newton means M1, L1, E minus 2, meter is L2, kg is M2. So can I say it will be M raised to minus 1, L raised to 3 and T raised to minus 2?
So is it 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11?
It is 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11, Newton meter square per kg square.
Yeah.
Just copy these 4 points. Once you are completing, please give me some guidelines or hint that you have completed.
Done, sir.
Done, sir.
What is net force acting at centroid if three masses are situated at vertices of equilateral triangle? Net force at centroid. Any idea? Net force at centroid.
Zero.
Net force at centroid is zero. So this part is electrostatic ka help, magnetism, gravitation. They all the three are comparable to each other. So if I consider first mass, this will be force of attraction here, F1. Second mass will get attracted towards this point. Unit mass here will get attracted towards center of mass, towards the second mass here. This will get attracted towards this. So all these forces will be equal. So their resultant will be this way. So one upward, resultant of F1, F2, F3 is downward. This is F. This is F. Therefore, net force at centroid will be zero. If three masses touch each other, then what is net force at any one vertex, if they ask? Now, all are of same masses. So, net force at any one vertex, comma, F resultant is root 3 times F. That will be root 3 times G, product of masses upon distance between two is 2R square. Because when two circles touch each other, distance between their center is 2R. Just copy this much. Then mass capital M is split into two masses M1, M2 for maximum force, like we did in electrostatic. Charge is split into two, then for maximum force. Now mass is split into two, then I don't know whether you are remembering, each mass will be half of total. Hello?
Yes, sir.
And in case of charge, it was half of total. Followed?
Yes, sir.
Method, followed, you know, sir, how we do? By derivative. F is G M1 M2 by R square, which is G into M1 is M, then M2 will be M minus small m upon R square. F equals to G upon R square, small m into capital M minus M square. Derivative of force with respect to mass will be G by R square. Capital M is constant. So if it is constant into variable like 4x, 5x, 6x, derivative is that constant. So derivative will be M minus M square is 2M. For maximum or minimum, derivative should become 0. So 0 equals to G upon R square M by 2M. That means M minus 2M is 0. Therefore, M is 2M. So small m equal to M by 2. That means M1 is same as M2 equal to M by 2. Right, seventh point. And explanation, if you want, you can copy the one which I have explained. And if you can remember, then directly write. If two identical spheres made up of same material touches each other, are separated by distance nr, then f proportional to dash. Common mistake, we will write 1 upon r square, which is wrong. So if this is one sphere, this is another, both are identical, separated by distance nr, made up of same material. So F is proportional to 1 by R square if mass is constant. Here R changes means radius will change, mass will change. Only the material is same. So density is constant. So in this case, F will become G. Mass is 4 by 3 pi R cube into rho into 4 by 3 pi R cube upon N R the whole square. So we'll get F proportional to R raised to 6 upon R raised to 2. So it is proportional to R raised to 4. Important, because generally we write 1 upon R square. Copy and write full. then
yes sir.
When ever problem is based on weight, then always find relation of G, that is if G2 is n times G1, then weight W2 is n times weight W1. This year also they had asked one sum on weight. Weight on planet is how much if the radius becomes this, 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 something. So get relation between G. If G becomes 3/4, weight will become 3/4. Or G becomes double, weight will become double and so on. Right. Any of you know at surface what is acceleration due to gravity? Gm upon capital R square. Correct?
Yes, sir.
At height, what is g? Gm upon small r square, where r is r plus h. So G at height upon G on surface ratio will become capital R upon small r the whole square. Inverse. So height upar, total radius niche. G niche, capital R upar. Please copy these three formulas. 9, 10, 11, 12. Simple chapter. Easy to score. Don't miss any MCQs. I think you got some news. September will be your exam now, not on August. Hello? Hello?
Sir, it will not
come. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
In one newspaper, it came that it will be shifted to September. August chances is not there. But I feel September they may keep. Because still, on June 1st week, they will declare some 12th standard ka strategy. So June, July, August, at least 2 months, they will give gap for filling the form and then arranging the dates. When number of month increases, then chance of competition will also increase. And those who are studying from start, they may get saturated. Those who will restart, they may get upper edge. So be careful for all this. Don't get saturated. Plan well. Yes, wrote.
Yes, sir.
if H is very, very small than R, that means it is close to the surface of Earth, then G at height is G into 1 minus 2H by R, right? Now, we will lecture. क्या बोल रहा हाँ बात बोल रहे कुछ आइडिया नहीं है मैं आपको करता हूँ फिर से लेक्चर ही है मेरा मैं आपको नहीं 5:30 तक करता हूँ 5:30 तक मैं आपको कल इसलिए नहीं किया मुझे लगा आप बिजी रहेंगे तो हाँ हाँ नहीं मैं करता हूँ 5:30 तक If H is very, very small than R, then GH is G into 1 minus 2H by R. At depth D, G at depth will be G into 1 minus D by R. These two are very important. Sometimes they can ask you, when G at height is same as G at depth, what is relation between depth and height? So graph of G versus R, where R is distance from the center of Earth. See, inside G and H depth are directly proportional. So graph is a straight line till distance becomes radius. And then it is inversely proportional. So very favorite graph. From inside to the surface, it will be a straight line because directly proportional, then 1 upon r square, therefore it will be a curve. Draw. Write this 13, 14, draw graph. Did it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Effect of rotation on G. So if I consider a body of mass m situated on latitude, that means making angle theta with equator,
having radius capital R, mass capital M. When Earth starts rotating with angular velocity omega, then this body of mass M will perform rotational motion of radius small r equals to capital R into cos theta. So small r will become capital R into cos theta. Forces acting on the body is weight mg acting along the radius towards the center and centrifugal force m omega square r. This m omega square r we can resolve into two components. M omega square r sine theta along tangent and m omega square r cos theta radially outward. So we can say apparent weight of body comma mg dash will be mg minus m omega square r cos theta. So mg dash is mg minus m omega square small r is r cos theta into cos theta. So mg dash will be mg minus m omega square r cos square theta. So this is formula for apparent weight when body is situated on latitude which rotates with angular velocity omega. Mg dash is mg minus m omega square r cos square theta. That means weight will decrease when body starts rotating. Copy. Yeah, shall I clear this now?
Yes, sir.
At equator. What is theta at equator? Is it zero? Theta at equator, is it zero?
Yes, sir.
So apparent weight will become mg dash equals to mg minus m omega square r cos square theta, that is cos square zero. So mg dash will be mg minus m omega square r. Now for weightlessness at equator, mg dash will be zero. So mg minus m omega square r is zero. Mg equals to m omega square r. Omega equals to root of g by r. G is approximately 10. This is 6.4 into 10 raised to 6. Radius of Earth is 6.4 into 10 raised to 6. So I can write 100 upon 64 into 10 raised to minus 6 in root. That means omega is 10 upon 8 into 10 raised to minus 3. So omega is 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 3 radian per second for weightlessness at the equator. Copy? Important point again.
Hello? Yes, sir.
Completed this also? Condition? 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 3?
Yes, sir.
Sometimes they ask what should be the speed of rotation of Earth so that body feels weightlessness at the equator. It is nearly 17 times. See how. For weightlessness at equator, we know omega is 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 3 radian per second. So omega upon original omega will be equals to 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 3. Original is 2 pi by time period. So this will become omega upon omega naught, 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 3 into t upon 2 pi. So omega upon omega naught is 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 3. Time period of Earth's rotation is 24 into 3600 upon 2 pi. 2 pi, I can take roughly 12. 12 into 2 is 24. 6 into 4, 24. So this will become omega upon omega naught. 1.25 into 4 is 5 into 3.6. That is approximately 18. But because here it is exactly 18, but it will be less than 18. reason we have taken denominator 6, it is 3.14. So omega is approximately 17 times original speed. So if they say how many times, you can directly write 17 times. Okay. Yes, completed now.
Yes, sir.
At poles, theta is 90 degree. So apparent weight mg dash will be mg minus m omega square r cos square 90. Mg dash will be mg minus 0. Therefore, mg dash is mg. Thus, rotation has no effect on weight at poles. Copy.
Done.
So related to G and force, I completed everything. Now we'll see what is launching of satellite. Or first, what is satellite and then launching of satellite. What is satellite? Lighter body or heavier body as compared to planet or across which it is moving?
Lighter.
So any lighter body which revolves around heavier body under gravitational influence. Is called as satellite. Right. So please remember, Friday will be extra test on waves and oscillation from the sheet containing that 1 to 200 sums. That means waves and oscillation sheet. From this only I will do.
Dance.
Launching of satellite. How many stage rocket is required for launching satellite? For launching satellite, how many stage rocket is required?
Stages.
Two-stage rocket. Two or more than two-stage will do. For launching satellite, two or more than two stages. For launching satellite, two or more than two stages rocket is required. Copy it in this. Next class we'll see what will happen if launching is not. Completed?
Yes, sir.
So today we stop here. Tomorrow again we'll meet. Same timing. Slightly half an hour. I will try to extend tomorrow's class.